Hello dear friends, assalamu alaikum. I am Rajesh Kumar from the Department of English, Section B. My roll number is 129. So today my topic is artificial intelligence from the subject of Introduction to Computers Technology, that is supervised by Professor Sir Parvez Ali Khaskali. So before starting my presentation on artificial intelligence, I have a question to you, that do you know something about a little bit about artificial intelligence? If you know something about it, that's good, but if you don't know about anything, just wait, you can learn anything from this presentation and try to concentrate on it. So this is the outline of our presentation. We will discuss the artificial intelligence, like definitions, examples and the concepts. What do we mean about the artificial intelligence, and then the applications of artificial intelligence. There are 6 applications. We will also discuss these, and after that we will come towards the advantages of artificial intelligence. Then we will go then we will discuss the disadvantages of our artificial intelligence. So we are starting our presentation. Actually, there are 2 meanings of artificial intelligence. Do you know that? The first one is a branch of applied computer science that deals with making intelligent machines which work and react like human. And it is the first meaning or the concept of artificial intelligence. Then the other one is a machine or a computer program that learns how to do tasks like human, and it requires some intelligence. Have you got this idea? तो सबसे पहले हमें देखना चाहिए कि हमारे पास 2 मीनिंग्स हैं आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस के, और दोनों ही एक दूसरे से डायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड हैं. इसमें कोई डिफरेंस नहीं, लेकिन डिफरेंस थोड़ा सा है, वो मैं आपको बताता हूँ. सबसे पहले जो पहली मतलब इसकी मीनिंग है आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस की, वो ये है कि ये एक अप्लाइड कंप्यूटर साइंस की एक ब्रांच है. ठीक है, जैसे कि हमारे पास एक लिंग्विस्टिक्स है, जैसे कि वो ब्रांच ऑफ लैंग्वेज, साइंस ऑफ लैंग्वेज है. तो एक तो है लैंग्वेज जो उसको स्टडी करती है, और दूसरी होती है वो साइंस. ठीक है, तो इसी तरह ये एक आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, ये एक ऐसी साइंस है जो डील करती है उन मशीन्स को बनाने के लिए. वो स्टडी करती है उन, मतलब आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एक मशीन्स हैं, मतलब जो दूसरा सेंस है, तो जो दूसरी मीनिंग वो ये है कि आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एक मशीन से जिन्हों को एक इंटेलिजेंस दी जाती है, जैसे कि वो कुछ मतलब ह्यूमन की तरह सीख सकें और उनों की तरह ही एक्ट कर सकें, और जैसे ह्यूमन टास्क करते हैं अपने, उसी तरह ही बिल्कुल सिमिलर तरीके से वो ही कर सकें. फॉर एग्ज़ाम्पल, इन द दे कैन have the ability to think, they can imaginate, they can take the decisions. And nowadays you can give the intelligence to the machines. Do you know that we also have the intelligence? What is the difference between this and that? The difference is that we have the intelligence, natural intelligence given by the God in our mind. And this intelligence is artificial because it is created by the human being. Therefore, it is called as artificial intelligence. And through this intelligence, the machines can become intelligent and they can do their task like human. Okay. And in the today's world, you will see lots of the revolutions through this artificial intelligence. The every task can be done by a machine like a human being. Likewise, through the artificial intelligence, the computer can become superhuman. Why it can become a superhuman? Because they can do the task more accurately and perfectly due to their powerful thoughts. We have the thoughts. They can gain the thoughts, but their thoughts will be powerful than us because they are the machine, and the machine can do the task faster and strongly. They have some more abilities, so therefore they can be called as a superhuman. And then the examples of artificial intelligence are that speech recognition simply means that the ability of a computer to listen the speech of human. Okay, speech recognition means you have seen the Google, the voice typing and the voice input system. We speak and we search through that, through our speeches. And then object recognition means the computers can detect the objects. They can see through their cameras. And another example, Siri is a good example of the artificial intelligence used in the iOS, in the Apple iPhone. How it is used? It can be used that I can give the instructions to Siri to do the task. For example, I say that call Kashif. So by my voice, the Siri will call to the Kashif, and it is the artificial intelligence. Through that, the mobile can work, the computer can work. It is the type of also, the mobile is also type of the computer. And then Google Maps, it gives the best route of our way. For example, there are lots of traffic on the road, so we will lose our time, we will waste our time. So through the Google Maps, we can see the direction. It can give us the direction, and through that we can reach at our position in the short time. And then there are lots of other examples like driverless car and DeepMind, AlphaGo, and many more. There will be many more in our future. So you are looking at this car, how it is an amazing. So it is a driverless car, and there is no need of a driver to drive it. It has artificial intelligence. Through it, it can see through the cameras. It can it has the sensors. There are lots of abilities in this car. So we have to sit in this car and give it the direction. It will be reach at our position. So this is the artificial intelligence applications. हमारे पास छः applications हैं artificial intelligence की, जो हम आगे discuss करने जा रहे हैं. वो ये हैं कि first one is a expert system. Expert system simply means a computer program designed to act as an expert of particular field or domain. Likewise, you have seen the doctors in their field, and we study in the computer science, we study in the English department, we study in our statistics department. So these are the fields. If we study and we give the time to that field, we will become the expert. So this is also the ability of a computer. They can become the expert of any field. We can make them, we can make a doctor, we can make a physician, a surgeon, a lecturer, a manager, a businessman, a geological explorer, and many more. They can become the expert of their field. So in the future time, if we want to learn something, we can also learn from the machines, the computers. They can teach us to become a lecturer. So after that, another application of the artificial intelligence is that natural language processing. Natural language processing means as we are speaking here, the English language and Sindhi language, Urdu language, Spanish, German, everyone has their own natural language. So, and you know that the computer only understand the binary language, that is in 0 and 1s. But actually the goal of the artificial intelligence is that they should understand the language of human being. Okay, they can communicate in the natural language, they can understand the natural language. And there are also other applications which are these. There are speech recognition. The third one is the speech recognition. Speech recognition means the through the speech recognition, the computer machines can understand the voice or the spoken words of human. Like there is a computer. I want to speak with it. So I do not need to write, but directly I have to speak. They can understand. So actually the speech is more important than written form for the AI, because through the communication process we always do not write. Commonly in our daily life we try to speak more than we write. So likewise we have the example of Siri. We have already discussed speech recognition, and then another, we have a Google voice input to convert the speech into written form. Every time we try to search our topics or our ideas on the Google through the voice input. For example, I have to learn the computer science, or I want to learn the artificial intelligence. So I will click on the voice input on the Google. I will speak that what is an artificial intelligence. So the Google will convert it into the written form, and it will search through that engine, in that engine. So this is the good example of speech recognition. And then the computer vision. Computer vision means the ability of a computer to see through attached cameras. Its attachment of cameras. They can see like human. They can detect like a human. Wherever we do not have to speak, but we always try to see the things. So if they want to make the machines like a human, it's very necessary to have the computer vision. They can see like human. Jaise ke insaan dekh sakte hain to computer bhi dekh sakte hain. For example, face recognition and the detection of object and people. And we have also example of Android face lock. As you know that as a security, we try to make a lock on the face, to try to create on the face lock. For example, I have a smartphone. I want to secure it from the other people, and they do not they cannot open it. So sabse pehle main apna jo face hai wo detect karunga apne lock ke upar, par ye hai ki uske andar mobile ke andar wo hona chahiye. To ye ek example hai face lock Android phones ke andar. Jaise ki wo kisi aur ko dekhega, uski camera, uska jo sensor hai wo kisi aur insaan ko dekhega jo iske andar pehle se detect kiya hua nahi hai, तो वो मोबाइल ओपन नहीं होगा, उसका लॉक अनलॉक होगा ही नहीं. जैसे कि मैं इसका ओनर हूँ और मैंने अपना जो फेस है वो डिटेक्ट कर लिया है आगे, तो वो मैं जैसे ही उसको ओपन करूँगा तो फिर वो ओपन हो जाएगा. सो दिस इट वाज द कंप्यूटर विजन. एंड देन द रोबोटिक्स. एक्चुअली द गोल ऑफ आई इज टू मेक इट अ रोबोटिक शेप, बिकॉज द रोबोटिक इज द शेप ऑफ अ ह्यूमन बींग. वाइल द रोबोट इज अ इलेक्ट्रोमैकेनिकल डिवाइस, and it can be programmed and reprogrammed for some change. If we need some of the changes, we can reprogram it, and it can move its parts, and also it can move itself like human. Its structure is physically, its structure is similarly to the human. You will see that it is similar to the human. And then the example of robot is Honda robot. A good example of robot is Honda robots in AI, and it can walk, it can see the things, it can listen, it can it has a speech recognition, it can communicate and understand the language of human. So this is the Honda robot example. And then automatic programming means the programming that is done by the computer itself, the type of programming it in which some mechanism generates a computer program to allow the programmers to write the program in higher language. As we discussed the natural language process, through this the computer can understand directly the higher language, and they can use the make the programs through the higher language. And it means that the human language, it can understand the human language, but the main thing is that the computer can be programmed by itself. If it needs some of the changes, so the programming can work by itself. We do not need to program it by ourselves. They can use it by itself. And then we are coming to the advantages. I think you have become bored, but do not think it is a boring. It was a good and interesting topic, because while you listen, while you learn something new, and you feel a good ideas, and you gain the good ideas. So the advantages of artificial intelligence is that AI requires no breaks and refreshment like human. Like we become tired, and we are always tired to distract from our goals, and we cannot manage the time and seasons. There are effect of time and season, like the weather problem, the temperature of our environment. So we change our thoughts and we change our feelings, but the robot, the artificial intelligence, cannot be affected by it. And then another advantage is that it can work for long hours and can be programmed for some changes. It can work for long hours. And then time saving, it is really the time saving. Through if we use the speech recognition and we use GPS, so it is time saving also. And then less need of employee in a company. For example, we need lots of employees, so we can use it. And we have to give the salary to our employees in every month, so we can save our money. And then it has it can find some errors done by human, like spelling mistakes and grammatical errors. Means it can also find some of the errors we commonly use, and the people always do the mistakes. And other advantages of that are face detection on social media. And we can handle our huge amount of data for processing and storing. And then we can utilize to overcome the limitations of human. And then they can perform difficult tasks and accurate work with more perfection. And the chances of error can be reduced. So these are the advantages of artificial intelligence. So we are coming to the disadvantages. There are lots of disadvantages also. You know that every coin has two sides. So the artificial intelligence technology also has some of the disadvantages. Like the first one is a high cost. It is very costly to be purchased. And then lack of personal connections. You know that in this time, we use more our computers and mobile phones, smartphones, so we do not give our time to our family, and we are less communicated with our family members. Therefore it also affect on the relationship. And then there is no replicating humans. And then addiction, Addiction means we will become the addict. It will be difficult to away from it, and we will not do the things by ourselves. We will depend, and we will be addicted on that. And laser jobs, it is highly the bad aspect of artificial intelligence. We can lose our economy through the jobs. For example, in an organization there are lots of people are working, and in the world there are billions and trillions of people are working, and they are doing their job. But you know that if the artificial intelligence will work instead of them, so what will be the consequence? How they will earn the money and how they will do their task? So it is also the bad aspect of this artificial intelligence. So thank you very much, and try to learn the things. And if you find any kind of question, if you don't clear the concept, you can also recap this video. You will feel some of the changes. Friends, bye, and thank you very much. Please subscribe my channel and like this video and click the bell icon to get the notification of new videos.